Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness. And all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice. Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. The path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
What's that?
It's a wall.
It's a door.
No, it's a bridge.
No, it's not.
Push it.
Push it. Push it down.
What do you think will happen?
Come on.
Behind the veil, don't we? But once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Into the relentless darkness. All that lurks within it can see you too.
She's so weak. She's so weak. They can see you're weak.
Stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Yes. Look how much it's changed.
behold that. Looks the same, but feels different. An imposter world, where the forest itself is watching.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls